my channel. My name is Gracie, and today I would like to talk to you guys about how I know that I'm chosen based on my childhood experiences. So, as a child, I was highly psychic. I had very strange psychic gifts where I was able to see both light entities and dark entities. And I'm very good at detecting dark energies around. I remember as a kid, the lady I grew up with would always tell, the lady that I grew up with, she's not my real mother, but so I call her the lady that I grew up with. And later on you find out why I call her the lady I grew up with. I want to address her as mom. She would tell me, oh, you were such an annoying kid growing up, like I would just let you cry by yourself. You used to cry so much. This lady wasn't aware of the reason why I used to cry a lot. But I remember myself lying down on the bed. It was a baby crib that was close to a window. And I used to see this figure that used to stick its hand through the window and pinch my skin. A very demonic creature, looking creature, right? And I used to cry a lot. And this lady wasn't able to see this. Though she's intuitive and she has psychic abilities herself, I don't know why and how she wasn't able to see that. But she can be, she's able to spot certain things as well herself, right? But I would always cry because of these things would torment me, right? And later down the road, as I grew older, I would see like, say for example, I'm outside and I would see like dark figures, like dark clouds moving around, right? And I would see maybe like a cat appear from nowhere and vanish. Just like that, you know? And another incident was, which I don't want to talk about. How I was able to, yes, I had great intuition as well. Like my intuition, my intuitive abilities were very much on point. Like I would even hear a voice, like my guides, I believe they are my guides, right? For instance, like I'm walking down the road and there's danger ahead of me. I would hear a loud voice, stop, in my head, stop, right? And I'm like, okay. It's almost like there's someone right next to me, walking with me, but it's not, there's no one right next to me, but I'm hearing the voice in my head, right? And it'll be like, turn around, run, like that loud, you know? And yeah, that saved me a lot from a lot of it saved me from a lot of danger, a lot of trouble, you know? And yeah, that's about it with my intuitive abilities. Another thing would be I would attract people that would come to this. It's like I would have people, right, come to me, and these were like people of all age groups, right? Adults, maybe in like their 30s, their 20s, their 40s, their 50s. They would just come up to me and they'll start telling me their story. They're going through something. You know, I'm going through this, and you know, I've been abused and hurt. This person did this and that to me. And then I'll be like, okay, and what am I supposed to do about that? I'm only 10 years old. You know, how am I supposed to help? Because these people will tell me, you know, God has directed me to talk to you, to seek advice from you. And I'm like, you're 30, 40, you're older than me, like. But I remember going back, recalling the advice I used to give this lady. I used to call mom, because this woman, she had a really messed up relationship with her husband. And every time I would see them arguing, I would always give her really good advice. Like I would tell her, you know, he doesn't respect you. You know, we should walk away from him. We should take our things and leave him. He's very disrespectful. Like I would say stuff like that, right? So I believe I came down to this earth with all this information, because now when I look back, the information I used to give this woman as advice, was exactly the advice I'm supposed to be giving people now. But this woman was so jealous of me that she started doing something to me that was sort of like trying to brainwash, trying to erase this information that I have on my mind to try to like build me into a person like herself, right? And I actually read up on this. It's called Illuminati Satanic Programming, where they take an innocent soul and they erase the, it's like, because we come to this earth with information, right? And so what she was trying to do to me was erase all this information that I knew and try to mold me to be a person like herself, toxic and pretty much a person who does do the opposite of what I'm supposed to be doing, right? So back to the story about the people coming to me for advice, right? And I recall telling these people sometimes, they're like, okay, you know what, I'm just a child, I don't know what how I can help you, but you know what, maybe try to talk to a church pastor or somebody like that. They can give you better advice than I can. And they're like, no, but God is directing me to talk to you though. And I'm like, you know, this is strange. But I remember like when I was in my teens, at the age of maybe like 17, I was reading the Bible and I read the story of Jeremiah. Jeremiah had a calling on his life. And he was a young person too. And he used to tell people the same statement I was telling people. Like, oh, I'm so young, I'm too young, I can't help you, you know. You need to seek somebody else, you know, who's older and wiser, can give you advice, right? He was running away from his calling, which is what I was doing at that time, right? Because I felt like I was too young to advise anybody about anything. Another thing would be near-death experience. I actually passed away, that was like, 2011? Yeah, 2011, I was gone, I died. No, it wasn't 2011. It was 2009, when I had my first surgery. I actually passed after the surgery. I lost a lot of blood. I woke up, everybody was crying, and people were like, oh my God, you were gone. My body had changed color, my palms, everything, like no oxygen supply. And that's how I actually suffered from brain damage, right? Yeah, so that said about the near-death experience. And another thing is that we chosen ones tend to believe in ourselves. People might not see what we see. Like, for example, like, people like, how the hell are you, like, let's say you were in a tumultuous situation. For instance, when I wasn't able to walk, right? In 2009, I had a surgery and a lot of people doubted I was ever gonna be able to walk again. But somewhere at the back of my mind, there was this voice that was telling me everything is going to be fine. You will be able to walk again. Though it didn't look like it, because when I was walking, I couldn't move my legs. Like if I was using crutches, right? At that time, I wasn't able to move my actual legs. I was moving my entire pelvis, guys. Yeah. My legs were like, especially the leg that was operated on, I wasn't able to move it. I suffered from something called avascular necrosis. Very painful. This is like 100 times worse than labor pains, right? And everyone that was around me was like, this is it for her, like she's never gonna be able to walk again. But somehow I knew at the back of my mind there was a little voice that was like, you will be able to walk again, trust and believe. Like we chosen ones will always, like, we know we'll always prevail in a situation. We might not know how. You know, and this is not the only incident that I've experienced this. For instance, when I was in school, right, I suffered from brain damage and I was suffering from brain fog at the same time too, right? So the brain damage from the surgery and the brain fog from, you know, narcissistic abuse, nobody believed in me. People didn't even, the mental health department didn't even want to give me help because they're like, she doesn't even look like she'll be able to make it. You know, like, it's like we can tell that there's something wrong with. People would walk up to me and be like, have you suffered from brain damage? Because you seem confused every time I see you in my class. I remember this lady, Julie Clark. She was the head of the biology department. She walked up to me one day when I was in the biology department. And she's like, hey, I've seen you in my class. you know, because that was like biology, first year biology. And she used to teach first year biology. She's like, I've seen you in my class. It seems like you have a very hard time absorbing information. I mean, this is a class with 5,000 students, but yeah, she was able to notice me, right? And she's like, do you have any metal plates in your head? Did you ever suffer from brain damage? Like, people were able to tell, like, right after that surgery, that there was something not right. Because I wasn't able to make new memories, right? Because after I passed, it's like, you know, when you're dead, you're dead. Like, you know, like, after that, things are not supposed to continue. So my brain just, like, you know, when the brain, when you're dead, the brain doesn't get enough oxygen, right? So that's how your brain dies. And so I wasn't able to, I would only remember old stuff, right? The time that I guess, I would only remember my past, all the old stuff. Nothing, anything that's new. You'd ask me something that I just experienced a minute ago, and I couldn't tell you what just happened. Especially when it comes to academics, I was like, anyway, that's the story for another day. I'll make a video on that. But this lady, I mean, she told me, you know, if you need any help with your studies, I'm always here for you, you know. Yet the mental health department for the school turned me down like 6 times, and yet I had proper documentation. You know what they do for students like myself? Like, what they would have done for me was they allow you to take a book with you to the exam room, right? So whenever you're writing your exam, you can look through the book for answers, right? And they can give you extra time. They extend your examination, like your timing for the exam, right? They give normal students like maybe an hour. For you, they'll give you 2 hours, right? And you can take your books with you, your notes, whatever. They denied me that. Guys, when I'm saying God had my back, I did not know how I was gonna make it in school, but yet I was told, go to school, you will make it. And I'm like, but God, how? But it's like, God is like, listen, you will make it, just believe in yourself. I believed in myself. I did not know how I was gonna make it, but I knew I was gonna make it. And guys, I graduated with an honors. My graduation is in October. It took me longer to finish than everybody else. I had to take 3 courses at a time, and the school apologized. They're like, you know what? We're sorry for not taking care of your case. But at the end of the day, it's like, I could sue this school, but I chose not to. I just like my peace, guys. Like, I don't have a time finding a lawyer, or they did this to me, they did that to me. I mean, I could make so much money off of that, but I don't have the energy for that bullshit right now. Excuse my French. Yeah, I graduated with an honors, you know. So I made it. And I had to listen to my intuition a lot. I was guided to take certain tinctures, listen to certain frequencies to restore my brain, the cells in my brain. Brain damage like that, people don't ever recover from stuff like that. But I guess by the grace of God, and hey, I guess when you're chosen, right? So that's just one of the many examples that I can give. Yeah, so that's it for now. Yeah. Thank you for listening. Have yourself a great day, night, wherever you are. Bye now.